What changes in the field of human rights for the LGBT are taking place in Europe nowadays?
Well, on the one hand, there's a lot of good news. For example, in more and more countries, same-sex couples can now either get married or have a registered partnership, by now 22 out of 28 EU member states. There's more and more legislation, attitudes are changing. At the same time, we also see some countries that are backsliding, like, for example, Hungary. The new Polish government is not very LGBT friendly. So it's a mixed picture, but overall, I think we are making progress.
So, does the situation in Ukraine with the rise of LGBT people influence the question of Eurointegration of Ukraine?
Well, yes, it plays a role. You know, it's also a formal criterion for getting visa liberalization, for example. I think it's also very good that Ukraine says, you know, the protection of LGBTI rights is part of the process of European integration, apart from, you know, all the formalities, that this is part of becoming, joining a community of values. So I think it's very positive. And I also think, you know, it's not just about Ukraine joining the EU community of values, it's also about Ukraine becoming a leader in the region, as it was said today.
So one more question. Can you share your experience of motivation of LGBT society and youth in particular to fight for their rights or defend their rights?
Motivation? In what sense?
Maybe you can share your experience of motivation of the young people, and or how to motivate the young people.
How to motivate them? Well, you know, I'm not sure if they need motivation, because the people that I've met over the years are extremely motivated. The question is, you know, how much room do they get? You know, for example, if you can't do a gay pride march without being afraid of being beaten up, or if the pride march is banned, for example, you cannot express yourself. If you have to be afraid of the authorities, or if you have to be afraid of hooligans, if there is homophobia everywhere, if you cannot come out of the closet, then, you know, you can be very motivated, but you just don't get the room. That's why it's so important that the authorities are on the side of LGBTI people, that they ensure their safety, their freedom, that they support LGBTI rights, that they make sure that, for example, there's anti-discrimination legislation, that hate speech is banned, that gay pride marches get support and police protection where necessary. So the attitude of the authorities is very important.
Thank you. And what would you wish to Ukrainian LGBT and all those who struggle for LGBT rights?
What I wish, I wish that, you know, one day everybody can be, and not just in Ukraine, but everybody can be who they are freely, without fear, without shame, without, you know, and because I think, and I said it in my speech, if we live in a society where everybody can be themselves, then we use the full potential of all people, because there is a lot of potential here, but you can only unleash that potential if people are completely free, and we all benefit from that. So that's what I wish for Ukraine and for everybody else.
And the last question, what are your expectations from this conference?
Well, I think it's excellent, the fact that it's taking place, the fact that the authorities are present here and participating in the program. I mean, that's a very clear commitment from the side of the authorities, and I hope it will give a further boost to, let's say, to changing attitudes, also giving more visibility, raising awareness, providing more information to people, because I think still, you know, the main enemy of LGBTI rights is ignorance. People who have all sorts of funny ideas, who are afraid, they don't know. I mean, the word homophobia literally means, you know, the fear of gay people. So ignorance is something that we need to tackle, and I hope this conference will contribute to that.